Hey everybody, it's CompHelp. Thank you for watching this video in which I will show you how to make a rotating text in the program 3ds Max. This way we can finally, in this video, render out in a sequence of JPEG images. You can apply this image sequence to my last tutorial, which was in Sony Vegas. This way you can make yourself a rotating watermark. Okay, so yeah, my last video was in Sony Vegas, how to apply a moving watermark in your videos. Anyways, so people wanted to know how to do this, and I must say this is like my, I don't know, 10th take of this video, just because it's so much information. It's very easy, believe me, it's really easy. It's just that there's so much to explain that I don't know, it's a lot, and I'm trying to make this video as short as I can, so bear with me. All right, so let's go ahead and dive into 3ds Max here, and we can start, you know, working on stuff. Okay, so what we need to do here is this. I know it looks probably overwhelming. There's a lot here. Just follow along. Right click on the front view here, okay, the front viewport, and what we're going to do is actually drop a text in here. So we're going to go over to the shapes button here and click text. This is a text command. Now here we can go ahead and add whatever text we want. You can make it as long as you want, whatever. I'm just going to type VV, and now I'm going to drop this in my front viewport by clicking and holding, okay? And I'm going to drag it onto this, you know, black solid line just so I can keep myself, I'm going to use it as a guide, okay? Yeah, whatever, that's fine. So after we've done that, what we can do is actually change the font, okay? I'm going to change it to Arial Bold just for the tutorial's sake. Arial Bold, and we can even change the size of our text here if you want. I'm going to keep it at 100, and all right. So yeah, I'm just going to show you a rotating text. No modeling, no nothing, because I don't want to go too much into it. I don't want you guys to get lost. That's pretty much what I'm doing here. Okay, so we have our text, and now what we need to do is actually make it 3D, quote, quote, 3D. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to right-click the perspective view, and I'm going to use my middle mouse button. I can, you know, move around here. If I hold Alt, middle mouse button, I can rotate around here. And you'll see it's not 3D. It's just like, it says a few lines. That's what it looks like to you, right? Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to, first off, right-click in my active viewport. See how text is still activated or it's still on? If I start clicking everywhere or clicking and dragging, I'm going to just keep making text, right? Let me go ahead and Control-Z those out of here. What you need to do is right-click in your viewport to get rid of that command, okay? And now we can start selecting again. Great. So select your text, okay, and we need to add a modifier to this. This way we can make it, quote, quote, 3D. So let's go over to our modify panel here and drop down this modifier list. And we're going to select extrude. Boom. Bring the amount down to negative 20 or 20, doesn't matter. I'm going to bring it down to about negative 20, okay? And I'm going to right-click the perspective view, and I'm going to start rotating around here, you know, orbiting around this, and you can see, yeah, it's 3D now. We have some text here. All right, so cool. We have 3D text, and now where do I go from here? Well, right-click the perspective view. Okay, if you're still right-clicked in the front view, you can see which one is activated by the yellow lines around this viewport. Right-click the perspective view and press F. This will bring us to the front view, just as you see right here. And now we're going to press Z. I like to work in the perspective view for everything. It's just my workflow. I recommend you do it as well. You don't want to mess around in all of them, or else you'll get yourself messed up and you'll get lost. Anyways, so we're now in the front view here. We have a front-facing view, and you can see right here in the cube, if I can change the right, whatever, you know, you can go and flip around here. So we're in the front view, and press Z so we can center ourselves on our selection. And now, oops, there we go, perspective Z, front view, Z. Okay, anyways, sorry about that. I was on orthographic, not good. anyways, ignore that. That's not going to happen to you. We are now in our front view, and what we need to do is actually change the color of our text. What you're seeing right now is the wireframe color. If I click off or deselect, you'll see right here in our wireframes, it's blue. If I select our text here, or our, and I start moving around here, and I say, red, okay, and I click off, you see that our text has changed color and our wireframe has changed color. Well, that's not exactly the right way. That's not the right way, actually, to change the color of your text. Let me go ahead and show you right now, okay? Let's press M for this, for the material editor, or you can find it right here. serial editor. And see these gray balls? We need to drag one of these guys onto our text. Boom. Now if I render this, let me right click in our front view right here in the bottom and render this with this teapot. You'll see we are now in our front view. It's rendering our front view, our active viewport, and it's gray. That's the color of the ball, right? Well, let's go ahead and change the color of this ball. Let's go over to the diffuse color and click. And you'll see something that looks similar to what Photoshop, if you watch my videos. We can actually change this in real time here. Let me move this rendering let me just X out of it. You'll see it in real time right here in the front view. It is changing color. Me, I want to make it red. Okay, so I'm going to rip this sucker, the saturation to all the way up to 255, and the value bring it down some to make it like a dark red. Okay, I'm going to click OK. And now if I render this again, you'll see now our text has successfully changed color. All right, so that's how you change the color. I'm not going to go more into detail on materials or anything, so we can actually exit out of the material editor. Great. So now what I need to do is actually change this black background, okay? Make sure you follow along because this is pretty important. You want to change the color of this black background because this is the black background that we will be chroma keying out in the Sony Vegas program. Okay, so let's say your logo has a black outline or something. If you chroma key the color black out, that outline on your logo is also going to be gone. So I'm going to change this to a light green because it has nothing to do with my logo, has nothing to do with the colors I have in this project. Okay, so what we need to do is change the background for like the 15th time that I said that. Let's go over to this environment and effects dialog button here, and you'll see we have a background color. Let's click it, and I'm going to move it to green. Remember, this right here, if you model yourself a 3D logo or something, if you want to go advanced and do that, and you give yourself a material with your colors in it and stuff, make sure that this background color has nothing to do with your logo colors or anything. This way when you chroma key it out, it won't affect your logo. Okay, you'll know what I mean if you mess up and go to Sony Vegas and everything is just kind of like disappearing on you. So anyways, I'm going to select light green, in this case like a green screen. Okay, and I'm going to click OK. Let's render this again. Boom, I have a green background. Pretty cool. All right, so we are pretty much finished setting up our text color. We have added ourselves a text. It's 3D now. We have a background color that we're ready to chroma key out. Now what we need to do is animate this. Go and X out of our rendering, X out all of that good stuff. So right here in the front view, what you need to do is actually press auto key right here. And this is pretty much telling Max, okay, start recording every little movement that I do as I move along in time. See this time bar right here? This is time. This is frame 0, 5, 50, and 100. This is 100 frames right here. If you want your animation to be longer, go over down here to the time configuration button, click it, and you'll see that you can change the length to, let's say, 110 frames or whatever. I'm going to keep it 100, and you can see that we're working with 30 frames per second. Okay, so every second, 30 frames goes by. Okay, pretty simple so far. Let's click OK. I just kept everything the same. Nothing changed. Okay, so I'm going to rip this sucker to 100. Okay, boom, 100. Now, this has not animated anything. If we go back in time, nothing is animated. Go to 100, and we need to make this rotation. We need to make this text rotate. So, select our text and press A. A for angle snap, because we're going to be rotating this, and we want the angles to snap to nice increments. Now, press E. Or you can go right here to this rotation button right here. And angle snap is actually right here as well. So make sure angle snap is on. Boom. And make sure the rotation is on. And now what we need to do is actually grab this green gizmo here. See the gizmo? Grab the green bar and rotate it. See these yellow numbers up right here? And they even show right here on the Y values. Rip that to 360 degrees. Okay. Boom. Now we've just rotated our logo 360 degrees. And because we have auto key on, it recorded that data. See this right here? Boom, keyframe. Boom, keyframe. It did that automatically. So let's turn auto key off. This way we can't mess up anything else. If I change the color now while the auto key is on, what it's going to do, it's going to animate the color. And we don't want that, okay? So anyways, if I press play, you'll see that now our text is rotating. Pretty cool. And it's just going to keep going on and on until we press pause. Okay, so I think we're ready to start rendering this, okay? We have our rotating text, we have our color, we have the background color all set. We're good to go. All right, So, and just so you know what I'm talking about, if I, you know, bring it to frame 25, no, 25 is not going, 20 and render this, it's going to render the current frame you see right there, okay? Let's go ahead and start rendering this. Sorry, it's 10 minutes already. Jeez, I'm trying to talk fast here. Let's go over to this right here, the render setup. Let's click that. And what we need to do is lately, or what we've been doing is rendering a single frame. What we need to do is render the active time segment, which is right here, 0 to 100. Okay, so let's render that active time segment. And 640 by 480 is an okay size right now, because if you're going to be applying this as a watermark, then I mean, you're going to be sizing this down anyways. So 640 by 480 is fine, and it's going to reduce your rendering times. Okay, so I mean, it's totally okay. If you for some reason want to render HD, if you're going to be making this, if you want this to be like a intro for some reason, what you can do and make this HD quality, you can bring the output size and put it down to HDTV, 1280 by 720, that is 720p, or 1080p is right here, 1920 by 1080. Okay, I don't know why you would do that for something so basic, but I mean, hey, options there. Let's go back to custom. 640 by 480 is going to be just perfect for us. And what we need to do, and the final thing we need to do, is go to the render output and click files. I'm going to actually go to my desktop here. And I'm going to make a new folder. Okay, so click this create new folder, and I'm gonna name this sequence. Cool. So let's double click on our sequence to get inside of it, and now file name, frame. Just type in frame. Save as type. Yes, you can save this as an AVI, but I don't like the way the quality comes out, and I like to render in JPEG, and this is more of like a rendering video, a tutorial. I'll go over this more in like one of those videos, but yeah, just click JPEG file and click save. Best quality, click OK. Great. So now what this is going to do, it's going to render 100 different frames, all as JPEG images in the best quality it can, and it's going to drop them in the sequence folder that we made on your desktop. Whew, that was a mouthful. Let's click render. And yes, because I messed up in my last video. And there we go. Each frame is, it's rendering right there. We're already rendered 50 frames, and we're good to go. 70 frames. Okay, so, boom, 100 frames. It took, I don't know, what, 15 seconds, if that, to render 100 different frames. And we're pretty much done with 3ds Max here. Let me X out of this. I can even minimize this. Let's go to sequence. This is the folder we made. And to my dual monitor here. This is the 100 different images that 3ds Max made for us. Okay, there we go. So if I double click this and click next. There you go. You see, it's like a rotating logo. I mean, the quality is not going to be amazing because it's a scaling renderer, and we haven't added any lighting or anything. It's very basic, but I mean, it's good enough to add as a watermark. Okay, because it's going to be small. You're not going to be able to tell the quality difference that much anyway. So there you go. That's how you make a image sequence with a chroma keyable background. It's very simple. Just a lot of explaining, right? I mean, this video came out to how many? 15 minutes. Wow. I'm sorry about that. I don't know how you guys can stand to listen to me for that long. But yeah, it's very simple to do. I just showed you right now. As long as you followed along, you should be good to go. I will be making 3ds Max tutorials in the future, more on basic things. This was kind of more like, okay, you've never seen this program before, let's just dive into it and start getting into stuff. It was kind of wild. I want to show you guys the basic things about the program. This way you're not overwhelmed about it, because this program can be extremely fun if you just if you learn it the correct way. Alright, so anyways, thank you for watching this video. Hope this video helped you. Remember, you can apply this image sequence to my last video, which annotation will be somewhere around here. Click the annotation, you'll be brought to how to apply a moving watermark to Sony Vegas, using Sony Vegas to your videos. Okay, alright, before I leave, just check out a few links. Check out my Twitter account by going to twitter.com/comphelp, my vlog channel by going to youtube.com/vvphonevv. Check out my gaming channel where I make video, my gameplay videos, by going to youtube.com/jerrygames. And also, if you want to find out how to make some extra money online like I do, check out cashcrate.biz. There you go, guys. Thank you for watching this video. I'm going to go ahead and leave you guys alone now. Thank you for watching.